To study together. So see if you can slide your phone away for just a few more hours. I know you checked Facebook and you were gone. Put it on vibrate. If you don't know the person sitting near you, turn around and say hello. I think there's some people that don't know each other. And if any of you are sitting alone in a seat and want us to move up into a row where there's someone else sitting in the row, feel free to do that. So you don't have to sit by yourself. So we begin on page 326. As our student rabbi leads us in prayer.
At this hour, Israel stands as one in prayer. All Jews on earth unite through memory and hope. A people unafraid, unvanquished, says to God, this people you have formed still lives to tell your praise. Still lives to share this teaching with our youth. Our ancient journey has not reached its end. The faith implanted at our people's birth is realized from age to age. Our sacred covenant, this people, few in number, ventured forth to carve a lonely path through the wilderness with dreams of vines and fig trees, justice in the gates, the land at peace, together. And still we make our way across the desert. This people you have formed still lives to walk before you. Exiled once to Babylon, we learned the humanity of God. A second time, dispersed by Rome, we learn that humankind is one. The call still sounds. Eternity is ever present in your midst. A heritage of sacred purpose in your heart. Your past tells a story for all peoples. Your future holds a promise still unfolding. At this hour, Israel stands as one in prayer. All Jews on earth unite through memory and hope. We look at one another, we know who we are. We look to our Creator, and we know our strength. In pursuit of truth, this people lives, to serve the Most High for the sake of life. Behind us, pain and glory. Before us, holy work. Timeless words command us, towards eternity we gaze. Page 328. Just a moment, we'll begin our afternoon Torah service. Join me in the English top of the page. It shall come to pass in the fullness of time that the mountain of the house of God shall be established as the highest mountain and raised above the hills, and all nations shall flow to it. Then many people shall say, come, let us go up to the mountain of the Eternal, to the house of God of Jacob. And they shall say, teach us your ways, that we may walk in your paths. We give thanks today for a Torah of life, the way of kindness, mercy, and truth. May compassion be our source of sustenance now, as in our people's past. May our souls withstand times of crisis, and our hearts the inclination to evil. May the covenant of Abraham and Sarah strengthen our will to do what is right. May the qualities of mercy and goodness, love and forgiveness flow through our lives, and let us be strong in a perilous world. Let us open our hearts to the path of Torah. Before we will rise in just a moment to bring back our Torah into our midst and read, chant from it this afternoon, it is my honor to call up all those involved in our Torah service. First, we'll call up the Ark Openers, the Sweetman Weisberg family to join us in the Bima, and then all the rest of us who are going to be involved in the Torah service, our Torah readers, Gail Ehrlich, Carl Becker, Jane Drucker, our Aliyot, Neil Zaslavsky, Lisa Fried, and Josh Wyman. Everyone can come to the front row, except the Sweetman Weisberg family, who will join us now in the Bima. We rise together for Seder Kriyat Torah, service for reading of the Torah.
Vayehi bin Zoharon vayomer Moshe Kuma Adonai v'yafusu oivecha v'yanusu mesanecha mipanecha ki mitzion tetze Torah ki mitzion tetze Torah udevar Adonai Mirushalayim Baruch Shenatan Torah Torah Baruch Shenatan Torah Torah Le'amo Yisrael B'kedushato Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad Echad Eloheinu Gadol Adonainu Kadosh Menorah Shemo Gadlu Adonai Iti Unerom Mema Shemo Yachtav Lecha Adonai Hagidula Vehagibura Vehatiferet Vehanetzach Vehahort Ki
Please be seated. Our Torah portion this afternoon is from the very middle, the very heart of our Torah, from Parshat Kedoshim. Its name means holiness, and the words you'll hear in just a few moments, are those very words that get at the heart of what it is to be holy and doing what it is that we can with our lives that is godly work. And so it is my honor and my pleasure to first call as our Baalat Kriya, Gail Ehrlich, for the first Aliyah. And for the honor of the blessing, the Aliyah, I call Neil Zaslavsky. Ya'amod Noach Avraham Ben Chaim Yasol V'Hadas La Aliyah. All right. Okay, we're going to leave this here. I should also mention that our Torah scroll here is our Holocaust Torah. And it is really beautiful. You'll have a chance in a little bit to see it lifted. But it's also a little unwieldy. So we may take a few extra moments here to make sure we are giving it its honor. Yes, we do.
Baruch Adonai
Hamborach Leolam Vaed.
Baruch Adonai Hamborach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamim Benatan Latu Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Atah Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen.
Vayedaber Adonai al Moshe lemur. The Eternal One said to Moses, Daber al kol adat b'nei Yisrael, v'amarta Elohim Elohim kedishim tehihu, ki kadosh ani Adonai Elohechem. Speak to all the congregation of the children of Israel, and say to them, you shall be holy, for I, the Eternal One, am holy. Ish imu v'aviv tira'u, v'et shabtotai tishmaru, ani Adonai Elohechem. Revere your mother and your father, and observe my Sabbath. I am the Eternal One, your God. Al tifnu el halalim v'elohe masracha, lo ta'asu lechem, ani Adonai Elohechem. Turn away from false deities, and do not make molten idols. I am the Eternal One, your God.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu Torat emet v'chaye olam nata betochenu Baruch atah Adonai notein haTorah.
Amen. Thank you both. You can both stay here as witnesses. For our next aliyah, our Baal Koreh is Carl Becker, so I'll call Carl to join me now. And for the honor of the blessing, I'd like to ask that any in our community who feel that they are in need of healing, be that healing of the body or of the spirit, that this aliyah is going to be for you. To join us here at the Torah, to come offer the blessing. We'll say a Misha Berach prayer, a prayer for those in need of healing, be they here or elsewhere. We'll say that a little bit later in the Torah service. But right now, if there are any of us who are feeling that need to feel close to Torah, to feel close to our holy tradition and to God, I invite you to join us at this time. Ya'amdu kol ha'kahal sherotze refua la'aliyah. Carl will be chanting from us from verse 11. And for all of us here, we'll pass those out. And we'll, once those of us are up here, we'll do a little count off, make sure we all start together. One, two, three.
Baruch Hu et Adonai Hamborach.
Baruch Adonai Hamborach Leolam Vahed.
Baruch Adonai Leolam Vahed. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam. Asher bachar bonu nito amim, v'natan lanu torato, baruch atah Adonai, notein haTorah.
Amen.
Amen. Lo tignovu ולא תכחשו ולא תשקרו איש בעמיתו ולא תשבו בשמי לשקר וחילת את שם אלוהיך אני אדוני לא תעשוך את רעיך ולא תגזול, לא תלין פעולת שכיר איתך עד בוקר. לא תקלל חרש ולפני עיוור, לא תיתן מכשול, ויראת מאלוהיך, אני אדוני. לא תעשו עוול בעם משפט, לא תישא ונדל, ולא תהדר, בני גדול, בצדק תשפוט עמיתך. לא תלך רכיל בעמך, לא תעמוד על דם רעיך, אני אדוני. לא תשנא את אחיך בלבביך, הוכיח תוכיח את עמיתך ולא תישא לב חטא. לא תיחום ולא תיטור את בני עמך ואהבת ליראך כמוך אני אדוני.
Eloheinu melech haolam, asher natan lanu Torat emet, chayei olam natan b'tokhenu, baruch ata Adonai, noten ha-Torah.
Amen. Shakoach to all of you. May you all be blessed speedily with the healing you seek. For our third aliyah, our Baalat Kriya is Jane Drucker, and for the honor of the blessing, I'd like to call Lisa Fried. Ta'amod Chana Leudit Bat Ruvain Veloes La'aliyah. We're going to have to go to the next one, so let's be really careful.
Baruchu et Adonai Hamavarach.
Baruch Adonai Hamavarach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamavarach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch atah Adonai. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam Asher bachar banu mikol ha'amim V'natan lanu et Torato. Baruch atah Adonai Noten ha'Torah.
Amen. Mipnei seva tekum, v'hadarta p'nei zekhen, v'yareta me'elohecha ani Adonai, v'chi agor itcha, ger b'yaretzchem lo tonu oto, ki ezrach mikem. Yehiye lechem hager hagar itchem V'ahavta lo kimocha ki gerim hayitem be'eretz mitzrayim Ani Adonai lohechem Lo tosu avel b'mishpat B'amidah b'mishkal uvim surah me'ozne tzedek avne tzedek Efa tzedek v'hin tzedek yehiyeh lechem Ani Adonai Eloheichem Asher hotzeiti etchem me'eretz Mitzrayim Ushmartem et kol chukotai v'et kol mishpotai v'yasitem otam ani Adonai.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu torat emet v'chaye olam natah b'tuchenu. Baruch atah Adonai noten haTorah.
Amen. For the honor of lifting the Torah and helping to dress it, Josh Weinman, Yamod. Amagbia vegolel. What Josh and I are going to do. And Avi. Oh, he's the golel. So, hagolel. If he's helping to address the Torah. That's. So, what we're going to do for lifting the Torah, because this is our Holocaust Torah and it is so beautiful and actually quite large, I'm going to take. These two, it's a little bit different than our normal hagba. Josh is going to take the other side if he can. Josh, will you grab both handles? We're going to, on three, we're going to both lift. Well, let's move the microphone first. Let's make sure we rise together. And we're both going to take one, two, three, lift. And now come towards me. So. Lift it higher, so we're going to turn so they can see. We're going to turn ourselves. I'm going to go that way. Uh-huh. You're going to come around the other side so they can see the words. There we go. You can walk back a little the other way.
V'zot ha-Torah asher sa Moshe lifnei b'nei Yisrael al-pi Adonai b'yad Moshe. Lai, 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 yada, lai, 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 yada, lai, 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 lai,
as the Torah is being dressed and is, I know it looks like it's still standing up, but it's actually down. You may be seated. And just a quick word, for those of you that don't know, that this scroll came from what was Czechoslovakia, Slovakia, Czech Republic, from a city called Polna. It's actually outside of Budapest, about 75 kilometers. This Torah scroll is highly unusual because of its height and how big it is. We've had it already 25 years. When it came to us, it was already over 200 years old, according to the Westminster Scroll Trust, which is the trust that keeps all the scrolls. It's on permanent loan to Kol Ami. It is, it's a privilege and honor for us to have our scroll be an active part of the life of our congregation. And on our website, there's a whole page dedicated to it if you want to read more about it. And we'll link you to the Westminster Scroll Trust in London, England, to learn about the story of the Westminster Scrolls. We're going to do the Haftarah a little differently this year. Oh, wait, I'm jumping ahead. Forget about it. Ignore me.
We are still going to do the Haftarah a little differently this year, but it'll be after we offer a blessing for those in need of healing. And we're going to begin to sing our blessing, and we're going to include the names of all those loved ones who we're thinking of in the midst of our song. But what I'd like you to do before we begin our song is to call to mind someone in your life. Think of them. Think of what they look like on their best day. Think of them and send them your love and your warmth as we begin this healing prayer together.
When you try your best, but you don't succeed. When you get what you want, but not what you need. When you feel so tired, but you can't sleep. Stuck in reverse. And the tears come streaming down your face. Something you can't replace. When you love someone but it goes to waste. Could it be worse? Lights will guide you home.
This afternoon, our Kol Ami family is calling to mind Pat Abbey, Rebecca Alexander, Vivian Bernard, Gary Ashland, Christian Belsito, Dabby Blatt, Lee Bloom, Benjamin Brightman, Diane Coleman, Brian Garfield, Rick Goldstein, Lisa Irvin, Shelley Joyner, Gloria Cam, Sylvia Karp, Jeanette Kaufman, Rick Lead, Sam Liss, Debbie Nachmias, Jerry Premack, Margarita Ramos, Steve Reisman, Ivan Rosenberg, Tom Royer, Lowell Selvin, Michael Silverman, Max Snow, Dan Stopler, Carlos Torres, Herb Lenk, Yassi Hosseini, and anyone you'd like to add at this time. Shabbat Avotenu v'Imotenu. May they all merit refuah shlema.
The source of strength. Ooh. reap in joy. Those who sow in tears, will reap in joy.
I almost don't want to talk. So as I started to say, we're going to do the Haftarah, the additional reading from the Book of Prophets, in a slightly different manner. As you know, the Haftarah for this afternoon is the great story of the prophet Jonah.
Would you say it's a whale of a tale?
It is a whale of a tale.
He's past Rabbi Humor 101.
And I know it's a story that you've all read for many, many years. I know you all saw Pinocchio, and you thought about Monstro as being that whale. Do I have to go over the story of Pinocchio with you? The Disney version. You didn't know War of Worlds this morning, the first version, and now you don't remember Pinocchio? Oh, mauvais, Mir. We got work to do, ladies and gentlemen. This afternoon, we're going to chant the Haftarah blessings, and then we're going to take a look at Jonah in art, a very different way to view the Jonah story. So the bracha for the Haftarah is page 342, and would you join us together as we chant the Haftarah?
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Bachar banu.
Whoa. No, that would not be
Bachar
it.
Binviim
tovim veratzav v'divrehem hanemarim bet. Baruch Ata Adonai Habocher b'Torah uv'Moshe avto uv'Yisrael amo uv'Nviyei ha'emet v'Tzedek.
Is it changing? Whose is that?
No. Yeah.
Who's first? Go back. Ah.
There we go.
Well, you all know the story of Jonah, right? Jonah's called on a mission by God to go and tell the people of Nineveh to repent, make tshuva. And Jonah, from the 5th century, decides that he's not so cool with that. So he tries to flee. He goes down to the port in Jaffa, and he catches a ship to Tarshish. And on that ship is out in the Mediterranean, headed towards maybe Spain. Some people say somewhere on the African coast might be Tarshish. We're not so sure. Nineveh, of course, is closer to in Iraq, right? Mosul is Nineveh. Oh, that's a name you know, right? Nineveh's on the other side of the river. Mosul's on one, the new city's on one side. Nineveh's on the other side. Okay, and along the way, there's a terrible storm in the Mediterranean. Jonah's down in the bowels of the ship. Notice the bowels of the ship sleeping while everybody up on the top of the ship is just in panic because the storm won't subside and they're tossing things over to try and make the ship, you know, lighter. And finally, the men are casting dice, lots, and they figure they'll offer a sacrifice to the sea god. Oops, Jonah's turn. Jonah realizes Jonah's made God upset, and Jonah says, I'm avoiding my task, basically. So Jonah's tossed overside into the raging waters of the Mediterranean, and right? What happens? A great fish, our text tells us, swallows him whole. And after 3 days of agonizing inside the belly of this fish, Jonah is at the bottom. Remember, again, more bowels of the fish, right? Bowels of the boat, bowels of the fish, right? He prays to God. He atones for avoiding his tasks in the world, which is calling others to repentance. He repents himself, and after 3 days, the fish spits him out on dry land. So today, and there's more to the story, and I'm going to let Jeremy and Max take you through some of their pictures, but each of us has chosen a piece of art. So the piece of art that I have shared with you today is a former Soviet Jew who came to make Aliyah in Israel. He died only in 2008. He was born in the late 40s and grew up in the Soviet Union, former Soviet Union. This particular painting was done in 1977. It is called Jonah Arrives at the Port of Haifa. Okay. Yevgeny Abagaz is his name, is the artist's name. So I want you to take a good look at it, because we don't hear about Haifa at all in the story of Jonah. Remember, Haifa is the northern port of Israel, the great port of Israel. And if you look at this particular piece of art, okay, Jeremy, you have to come over here because I don't know how to operate your machinery. Oh, there we go. Okay. So, so simple. Okay. So first you notice, right? How's he dressed? Right? He's dressed like what we expected our grandparents to be dressed like when they came to America, right? He's dressed in very simple clothes. This Jonah, however, it's interesting. What does this Jonah have with him? He's got all of his belongings with him in those suitcases, right? Clearly fleeing something, much like our refugee ancestors came. Now, this is an interesting fish, right? Because the fish is docked. It's a gangway. He's coming down. This is a Jonah that wasn't thrown violently onto the shore. This is a Jonah that has walked with head held high down the gangway, right? Look, you can see the gangway calmly on the shores of where? Of Haifa, of Israel, of the promised land. So you have to ask yourself, what is the artist trying to convey in this piece of art? What is the task that this Jonah has to do? A different Jonah than the one we know in our Bible? This Jonah has come on Aliyah to resettle the promised land. This is a Jonah who's come from the bowels of a fish, the belly of the beast, if you will, the former Soviet Union. Like many of our ancestors who came out of Eastern Europe to resettle the promised land. And look at the promise. Look, there's other boats there in this port. Ironic for a painting done in 1977, right? This is not a painting that shows modern-day ships or even the ancient ships of Jonah's time. Look at these. They don't really go with the Jonah that we have here. They're also a throwback. Sailing ships, or you might say whaling ships. And look. What's happening here with our grand fish? What is our fish thinking? What is the fish? Is the fish become a mode of transportation? Is the fish wondering, where the heck am I? What is the fish thinking? And I think we have to imagine in the story of Jonah in our Bible, what was that fish thinking that swallowed a man and then was made, God made the fish spew out the man whole? I think my favorite part of this entire interpretation of Jonah coming to the promised land is this. The cargo that's sitting on the port. You see it says Z-I-M, Zim. Anybody who knows anything about Israel is the great cargo company of Israel is Zim Cargo. But that's in the modern day era, right? That's today. The great cargo line of Israel is Zim. So we have, what do we have in this particular interpretation of Jonah and the great fish? We have different eras clashing with each other, different generations talking to one another. We have the whaling ships of the 1600s and the 1700s of pre-modern Europe, perhaps, pre-emancipation of the Jew. We have the Jew, the refusenik, the refugee from the Soviet Union, walking on a gangway through the port of Haifa. We have a fish that's confused, that its task was changed, all coming to the modern state of Israel. Perhaps, and this is my sense of this particular piece, and only my sense, given the fact of its the painter and his own journey, is the fact that Jonah's task is to go to Nineveh, a city that's considered not a particularly Jewish city, right? They're idol worshipers, and Jonah has to go to confront the king. And at the end of the story of Jonah, Jonah's extremely disappointed that they actually did repent. Like, oh my gosh, they actually listened to me. Jonah kind of wanted there to be fireworks and for God to punish them. And here, in this story of this painting, we have to wonder, where is Nineveh? Is Nineveh some other city? Or is perhaps the reflection of us reading about the other is that we're really talking about our own need to repent, our own situation? And so I think in this beautiful, beautiful piece, we have a lot to think about of what Jonah's task was and is for each of us, and a lot to think about the role that the land of Israel plays, not only in the text that we read that Jonah leaves from the port of Jaffa, which is, of course, Tel Aviv, but this Jonah arrives to the northernmost port of Haifa to resettle a new promised land, to resettle our promised land, with the promise of redemption, to redeem the land, and to redeem the Jewish people.
Now for something totally different. So this piece really spoke to me. It's not actually a painting or a sketch. It's actually a copper plate engraving. And this was created by Matthias Marion the Elder, who lived from 1593 to 1650. Not a Jewish person, by the way. I don't know if we can make it out in here, but can we see it up there? There, even in some versions that I've seen, appears to be a cross up here in the sky. This one doesn't seem to, I'm not seeing it here, but this is the Jewish version, I guess. But one of the things I always find powerful about the story of Jonah is very similar to something that Rabbi Eger just mentioned, which is the universal themes in it. That Nineveh is not a Jewish city, and that Jonah, a Jewish prophet, is sent to this place to do this work with people who he might not really have any relationship with. To me, it emphasizes the theme, that element emphasizes the theme of God being the God of all people, of our people, but also of everyone, and that those gates of teshuva are really always open to those who will take them, and the people of Nineveh do. And Jonah is really not happy about that, if you remember chapter 4. This piece is actually called Jonah's Anger at the Lord's Compassion. Because what happens is, after Jonah's walking through the city for days and days, three days across and 3 days back, the people, they do repent. And God shows mercy on them and does not destroy their city. And so Jonah's leaving, and he's out, and he's waiting under this tree. And by some accounts, it's a plant or a bush with these gourds. It's hard to know. The Hebrew word is not really that decisive about it. But Jonah's waiting, and he's seeing, in this rendition, he's seeing God's mercy, the light. He's seeing the light that God shows upon the city of Nineveh when they've repented. And notice his posture. He is really sad about this. I mean, and to do this with copper engraving is like, you can almost make out his forlorn expression. He's really, really angry about this. I like to think also about this scene, because shortly after the scene that's pictured here, when God is trying to teach Jonah about why he cares about this city of people, formerly sinners, now who've done their tshuva, and God actually makes this plant wither and fade out, and he has the wind come and scorches it, and Jonah cries about this plant being gone and says, "Oh God, why don't you just take me? Why don't you just kill me?" And what he really ends up, God really teaches Jonah this lesson of, he says, "Jonah, you care so much about this plant when you didn't do anything to help make it grow?" And it's God saying, "I have a whole city of people that I love, that I deeply, deeply care about here in Nineveh, and that I created," right? This is the creator of all existence speaking to Jonah the prophet. So I like to think of this right before, and it's really interesting to me that Marian chose to capture Jonah's anger and God's mercy, and not really capture the lesson that God teaches to Jonah, but sort of hint at it, that just as Jonah is sitting here forlorn at what he's seeing, that's sort of what we can imagine God would feel if the people didn't do the work of tshuva that they so desperately needed to do. So, yeah.
Back on. There we go. The image that I have is, you may recognize it from last year. Last year, instead of a play or reading it through, we showed the video from Godcast, now called Bim Bom, formerly known as Godcast. And it's there's a song in the video. It's about a 4-minute video that tells the story of Jonah. And in the video, there's a song by the Josh Nelson Project. Josh Nelson is a singer, composer. We've sung many of his pieces together. Hava Nashirat, that's his. The Avinu Malkenu we did last night. Avinu Malkenu, that's his. And the Yehiyu L'Ratzon that we're gonna do in a little bit, that's also his. He's a very accomplished singer-songwriter, and he wrote this piece to tell the story of Jonah in a different way. And to me, so much of Judaism and what we are here to do is to figure out ways to take our tradition and transmit it to the next generation in a way that is relevant to them and also connects to them, that it's not just a pure translation, but that it's something that is meaningful. And what I love about this story and the way that it's told is that we really focus on Jonah, but when we look at the story, when we tell the story in a new way, we get the opportunity to really see ourselves as different characters. And what I love about this, the way that it's told, is that it makes me confront how in the last year I've seen myself as the different characters. When have I been God in this story? When have I been Jonah in this story? When have I been the people on the ship? When have I been those in Nineveh who are hearing a teacher's message and have to decide whether to listen to it or not? When do I be a father to the most adorable dolphin you've ever seen? This part of the story is, it's a little bit of a drash, but it's when Jonah realizes that he actually has to practice what he preaches. And what I like about this version is that it doesn't just end with Jonah in sorrow. He's among the people of Nineveh participating in the teshuvah. And that's such a reminder for us all that going forward this year, that we could spend all day together in services, reading all these things, Ashamnu, Bagadnu, all these things that we've done together in different ways. But if we don't do anything after we leave these halls, what's the point? To me, the point of Jonah is this, it's a lighthearted reminder that it's important for us to see ourselves in our texts, in our tradition, and figure out what it means for us, but that it doesn't just live inside a synagogue building. It doesn't just live inside a text study, chevruta. It doesn't just live inside a scroll. It's how we go out. It's how we live our lives in the world. And at the end of the song, Josh Nelson sings that the message of the story of Jonah is that this day is not about us alone, because we're all in it together. It's up to each one of us to make the world a little bit better, to find that home is where the heart is, to reach out to refugees, to be the angel we wish to see in the world, to do all these things. Because when we hold up a text, when we hold up a piece of Torah to ourselves, what we're really doing is we're not studying them. We're just holding up a mirror to ourselves.
Shikach. We'll conclude our Haftarah art with the blessing on page 351, I think. Hold on. I want to make sure that the right blessing. Yeah, 351.
Yep. Yeah.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Tzur kol haolamim Tzadik bechol hadorot Ha'el ha'neman Ha'omer ve'oseh Ha'medaber umkayem She'kol dvarav emet v'tzedek Al ha'torah ve'al ha'avodah Ve'al ha'nevi'im Ve'al yom ha'kippurim hazeh She'natata lanu Adonai Eloheinu Limchila ולסליחה לכפרה לכבוד ולתפארת על הכל, אדוני אלוהינו, אנחנו מודים לך ומברכים אותך. יתברך שמך בפי כוחי תמיד לעולם ועד, ודברך אמת וקיים לעד. ברוך אתה, אדוני, מלך מוחל וסולח לעוונותינו ולעוונות עמו בית ישראל, ומעביר אשמותינו בכל שנה ושנה. מלך כל הארץ, מקדש ישראל ויום הכיפורים. As we are about to return our Torah to the Ark, it is my pleasure to call forward the Sweetman-Weisberg family once again, as well as all of those who are going to be leading us in prayers for country, congregation, or Israel, that they may sit in the front row. And we rise together to return the Torah on page 352.
Yehallelu et Shem Adonai, ki nisgav shemo levado, hodo al eretz v'shamayim v'yarem peren de'amo tehila lechol chasid. Natati lachem Torati al ta'azovu Etz chayim hi lamachazikim ba v'tom ve'ha me'ushar derachecha darchei noam v'chol Tivotecha shalom Hashiveinu Adonai Elecha v'nashuva Chadesh, chadesh yameinu Chadesh yameinu
Please be seated.
Good job.
We ask Bob Wiener to join us and lead us on page 284. If you'll turn in your machzors for the prayer for our congregation. There it is, a nice big print.
Eternal presence, who blessed our mothers and fathers, bless this holy congregation, a house of study, prayer, and righteous deeds. Together we give thanks for our leaders, those who learn, teach, and uphold the Torah, inspiring others to learn, teach, and uphold the Torah, those who do the sacred work of building our community. May their service bring them joy, fulfillment, and purpose, and may they go from strength to strength. For our members, diverse in age, interest, and background, Jews by birth, Jews by choice, and those of other faiths who join with us, all who offer their time and talent, their love and commitment, for all who come here on this holy day of Yom Kippur to share the search for meaning and renewal. Your presence is a blessing, your friendship a gift. May the spirit of peace, dignity, and respect live within these walls, inspiring us to care for one another with compassion, and may we be a source of goodness, light, and healing for the world. May the one who blessed the generations before us bless us as we stand together this day. One congregation joined with all Jewish communities of the world through our prayers on this Day of Atonement. Let us renew ourselves for the year ahead. Let us honor the precious legacy that is ours.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And now we ask Emmett Block and Vanessa Spino on page 286 to lead us in a prayer for our country.
God of holiness, we hear your message. Justice, justice you shall pursue. God of freedom, we hear your charge. Proclaim liberty throughout the land. Inspire us through your teachings and commandments to love and uphold our precious democracy. Let every citizen take responsibility for the rights and freedoms we cherish. Let each of us be an advocate for justice, an activist for liberty, a defender of dignity. And let us champion the values that make our nation a haven for the persecuted, a beacon of hope among the nations.
May our actions reflect compassion for all people within our borders and abroad. May our leaders and officials embody the vision of our founders to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and to our posterity.
We pray for courage and conscience as we aim to support our country's highest values and aspirations, the hard-won rights that define us as people, the responsibilities that they entail. We pray for all who serve our country with selfless devotion in peace and in war, from fields of battle to clinics and classrooms, from government to the grassroots, all those whose noble deeds and sacrifice benefit our nation and our world.
We are grateful for the rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness that our founders ascribed to you, our Creator.
We pray for their wisdom and moral strength that we may be guardians of these rights for ourselves and for the sake of all people, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.
And we invite Johanna Shore to lead us in the prayer for Israel, page 288.
Avinu, you who are high above all nations, states, and peoples, Rock of Israel, the one who has saved us and preserved us in life, bless the state of Israel, first flowering of our redemption. Be her loving shield, a shelter of lasting peace. Guide her leaders and advisors by your light of truth. Instruct them with your good counsel. Strengthen the hands of those who build and protect our holy land. Deliver them from danger, crown their efforts with success. Grant peace to the land, lasting joy to all of her people. And together we say, Amen. Amen.
Beautiful. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to invite the Secretary of our Board of Trustees, Carrie Davidson, has a few brief closing announcements, and then invite Lise Resch to join us up here. Yeah, I think so. Here. They're right here.
Well, look at that. It says Shana Tova. It's appropriate. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of Congregation Kol Ami, we would like to thank you for celebrating these high holy days with us. And we mean that. Thanks to our musicians, ushers, ritual pillar, and wonderful office staff who have contributed so much to making our high holy days really, really special. We want to welcome all of you who have joined us for the first time and have stayed through to the end here. We want to thank all the people who are listed in the program who did a bunch of things that you had seen and have been thanked. And in particular, We want to thank our major donors and Gibberim level donors who have supported the congregation so generously. And we invite you to be a part of these special giving circles. Upcoming events. So you've heard a lot about them. You can read in the bulletin, they'll tell you what they are. You heard about the possibility of traveling to Europe with Kol Ami next June, an 8-day trip, Warsaw, Krakow, Auschwitz, Budapest. Sunday, Sukkot, we're starting the Harvest Festival. Larger sukkah, how large, Rabbi?
It's pretty large. It's, like
it's gonna be huge.
Thank you, Jeremy.
It's the length of our, it's the cross length of our parking, width of our parking lot. It's the width of our parking lot.
The width of the parking lot, well. So, here's what we can do. We can fill it at Sukkapalooza on Sunday at 6 o'clock. And there's, so it's a barbecue dinner. When do we have to RSVP?
Now.
Right now. You can just tell me. It should be fun.
Just email or leave a message.
Email, leave a message, do whatever you like.
Tell the staff in the lobby.
So Rabbi Eger and student Rabbi Jeremy Gimbel will be there. And if you don't want the barbecue, they're vegetarian options. You heard about that. So let's see. Also, Mocha and Woka events in the sukkah Wednesday and Thursday, respectively. But I don't know which the order was. But I think it says in the bulletin.
It does.
Perfect.
Men of Kol Ami, women of Kol Ami.
Men of Kol Ami is when?
Wednesday.
Wednesday, and women of Kol Ami is Thursday.
Yes.
Perfect. It's good. It's nice to be prepared. And you know what happens? After we celebrate Sukkot, there's yet another holiday. That's good. So on Sunday, October 23rd at 8 p.m.
7.
Okay, well, it says 8. Okay. If you want to be on time, you'll come at 7. If you want to miss a lot of the singing and dancing, you'll come later. So Sunday, October 23rd, 7 p.m., we can celebrate Simchat Torah. It says it's continued on the next page. Thank you for coming to our Yom Kippur services. This is not right because we already did Yisker services. And we did Torah study and 12-step. And we're in the midst of the afternoon service. And Nila will begin at some point. So, Shana Tova. And so, now it is, in fact, my pleasure to introduce Elise Resch.
I promise you this is only going to be a couple of minutes. So I got a call from Sadie a couple of weeks ago saying, Elise, will you make the last pitch? I said, the last pitch? Does Kol Ami have a baseball team that I didn't know about? Are they going to have a last game and they want me to do the pitch? Huh. Let me see. Is this team all women or could it be all men? And I'm going to be the first female pitcher to make the pitch. Just like that. No TV show. I don't know if you've ever seen it, Pitch. It's great. It's about the first female pitcher in national baseball or something. And then I thought, well, gee, maybe if I do that, then the Dodgers will ask me to help them win the World Series. And I thought, come on, Sadie, don't you know what a klutz I am? That if you got me out there, I would be throwing all kinds of wild balls and make the teams lose. So before I got a chance to ask her that question, she said, or any of those questions, she said to me, I know it's the end of Yom Kippur. Everybody's going to be exhausted and stressed out and hungry, and nobody's going to want to hear another pitch. Ah, the pitch. That's what she meant. So she said, just let everybody know, just take a couple of minutes and let everybody know that this is your last chance during High Holidays to open up your hearts and your pockets and give something of yourself. If you have before, great. And if you can give a little more, that would be wonderful for this incredible synagogue. So I thought about it for a moment and I agreed to do it. And the reason I agreed to do it is because this synagogue means so much to me. I remember sitting around a table over 25 years ago with Rabbi Eger and a few friends talking about the possibility of starting a new synagogue with Rabbi Eger as our rabbi. And 25 years later, look at this. For those of you who were here last night, you heard all the amazing things that Rabbi Eger does, and she's representing us at Kol Ami in doing these things. So, so important to me. Rabbi Eger is a dear friend of mine. She has been with me for many, many difficult and painful times in my life. And most recently, for the most wonderful time, when Arlene and I got married in March. And if you look from time to time, these posters, the Kol Ami posters up there, you'll see the three of us, Rabbi Eger and Arlene and I, just after we've signed our ketubah. So it's in there. Unfortunately, she's not here today because she's at home in bed with a big ice pack on her knee. She's got a very bum knee. So I am hoping that everybody will join me in pitching in and you know, just really seeing how far you can go to support this amazing home for us and keep us going. So I thank you for listening to me, and Shana Tova, and I'm sure you have some cards to fill out and put in the basket. So. I told you it would only be a couple of minutes.
Well done.
Remember, utshuva, utfila, utzadaka, three ways to avert the severity of the decree. So this is one more opportunity for tzedakah. And we thank you, Elise, very much. Would somebody hand these back to Elise? Thank you, Gary. If you are still wanting to participate and help us with our Guatemala mission of bringing children's school supplies and backpacks and tennis shoes and clothes for preschool through 13 years of age, feel free to bring them on Sukkot when you come on Sunday or on Friday night. Over the next few weeks, we'll still be accepting donations for our Guatemala mission in January, and to be able to help outfit 100 children in our special city that we work with. At this time, we begin towards our the closing part of our day as we rise for the tefillah. If you'll turn to page 356.
Adonai Sefatai Tiftachu Fi Yagil Tehillatecha. Adonai Sefatai Tiftachu Fi Yagil Tehillatecha. Page 360. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu v'Elohei Avoteinu v'Imoteinu Elohei Avraham, Elohei Yitzchak v'Elohei Yaakov Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka Elohei Rachel v'Elohei Leah Ha'el Hagadol Hagibor v'Hanora El Elyon Gomel Chasadim Tovim v'Konei Hakol V'zocher chasdei avot v'imahot, Umevigula livnei v'neihem lema'an shemo be'ahava. Zochreinu lechayim melech hafetz b'chayim v'chotveinu b'sefer hachayim l'manacha Elohim chayim melech ozer u'moshia u'magen baruch ata Adonai Magen Avraham Bezrat Sarah 364 Atagi Bor Leolam Maronai Mechaye Akol Ata Rav Lehoshia Morid Hata Mechalkel Chayim Bechesed Mechaye Akol Berachamim Rabim Tzomech Noflim Verofech Olim Umatir asurim, umekayem emunato lishenei afar. Michamocha baal gevurot, umidomelach, melech memit umekayem, umatmiach Yeshua. Michamocha el harachamim, Zocher Yetzurav Lechaim Berachamim Lechaim Berachamim V'ne'eman atah l'hachayot hakol Baruch atah Adonai Mechaye hakol Nekadesh et shimcha ba'olam Keshem shemakdishim o'otho bishmem arom Kakatuv al yad nevi'echa Vekarase el zebe amar Kadosh, kadosh, kadosh Adonai tzevaot Adireinu Adonai, Adoneinu Ma'adir Shimcha bechol haaretz Baruch kevod Adonai Mimkomo Echad hu Eloheinu Hu avinu hu malkeinu Hu moshieinu Yashmienu Berachamav Le'enei Kol Chai Ani Adonai Eloheichem Yimloch Adonai Le'olam Elohayich Tzion Le'dor Ador nagid god lecha Ulenetzach netzachim kedushatcha nahakdish Veshivchacha Eloheinu Mipinu lo yamush Leolam vaed Ki el melech gadol Vekadosh
Continue silently through page 410.
ratzon im reifim ve'egyon libi lefanecha yehiyu le'ratzon im reifim ve'egyon libi lefanecha Adonai Tzuri Begoali Adonai Tzuri Adonai Tzuri Adonai Tzuri Begoali Yehiyu leratzon im refim refim Vegyon libi lefanecha
At this time, I'd like to call forward to the Bima, Evan Cohn, and Sam Feibisch to open our ark, and to the front row, Hope Faust, Martin Taller, Joe Perry, and Murray Blank. If you all come to the front row. And then Evan and Sam, if you'll join us on the Bima as we open our ark. We're turning in our Machzorim to page 416. And please rise as the ark is opened.
Ashamnu,
Ashamnu,
Bagadnu,
Bagadnu,
Gazalnu,
Gazalnu,
Dibarnu Dofi,
Dibarnu Dofi,
Ay, 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 Hevinu,
Hevinu.
Vehirshanu,
Vehirshanu,
Zadnu,
Zadnu,
Chamasnu,
Chamasnu,
Tafalnu Shaker,
Tafalnu Shaker,
Ay, 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 Yatsnu Ra,
Yatsnu Ra,
Kizavnu,
Kizavnu,
Latsnu,
Latsnu,
Maradnu,
Maradnu,
Niatsnu,
Niatsnu,
Sararnu,
Sararnu,
Avinu,
Avinu,
Pashanu,
Pashanu,
Tzararnu,
Tzararnu,
Kishinu Oref,
Kishinu Oref,
Ay, da, 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 Rashanu,
Rashanu,
Shishanu, Shichatnu,
Shichatnu,
Tiavnu,
Tiavnu,
Tainu,
Tainu,
Titanu,
Titanu,
Ida da 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 da.
Please be seated. We continue on page 418. For these sins, O God, we ask forgiveness. Al chet shechatanu lifanecha bezadon uvishgaga, v'al chet shechatanu lifanecha bezhivut shav. The ways we have wronged you deliberately and by mistake, and the harm we have caused you in your world through insincere promises. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha beflut, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha v'kalut rosh. The ways we have wronged you by judging others unfairly, the harm we have caused in your world by making light of a serious matter. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha beyetzer hara, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha be'einayim ramot. The ways we have wronged you giving in to our hostile impulses, and the harm we have caused in your world through condescension. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha behihur halev, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha bedibur peh. The way we have wronged you through our innermost thoughts, and the harm we have caused in your world through the words of our mouth. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha bechachash uvichazav, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha behona'at reya. The ways we have wronged you through lies and deceit, the harm we have caused in your world by mistreating a friend or neighbor. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha besinat chinam, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha bevidui peh. The way we have wronged you by hating without cause, the harm we have caused in your world through hypocrisy. V'akolam elohas lichot, slach lanu, machal lanu, kaper lanu. For all these failures of judgment and will, God of forgiveness, forgive us, pardon us, and lead us to atonement.
V'yal kulam Elohas lichot Selach lanu mechalanu Kaper lanu V'yal kulam Elohas lichot Selach lanu Mechalanu, selach lanu, mechalanu, kaper lanu.
Page 420. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha begalui uvitzater, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha bevli da'at. The way we have wronged you openly and in secret, and the harm we have caused in your world through our thoughtlessness. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha bechilul Hashem, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha betum'at shfatayim. The way we have wronged you by profaning your name in public, and the harm we have caused in your world through offensive speech. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha berichilut, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha bezizul horim umorim. The way we have wronged you through gossip and rumor, and the harm we have caused in your world through disrespect to parents and teachers. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha v'atzarut ayin, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha b'masal v'matan. The way we have wronged you through narrow-mindedness, and the harm we have caused in your world through dishonesty in business. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha begalui arayot, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha b'machal v'mishteh. The way we have wronged you through sexual immorality, and the harm we have caused in your world through consumption of food and drink. Alchet shechatanu lifanecha b'tishomet yad, v'alchet shechatanu lifanecha b'ritzat raglayim lahara. The way we have wronged you by betraying a trust, and the harm we have caused in your world through impulsive acts of malice. V'al kulam elohas lichot, slach lanu, mechal lanu, kaper lanu. For all these failures of judgment and will, God of forgiveness, forgive us, pardon us, and lead us to atonement.
V'yal kulam elohas lichot, selach lanu mechalanu, kaper lanu. V'yal kulam elohas Selach lanu mechalanu, selach lanu mechalanu, kapelanu.
Page 429, we rise for a singing of Avinu Malkeinu, who ask God Almighty to grant us grace and grant us acts of justice and love. Seated. We've concluded Mincha with that Avinu Malkeinu, and now we moved into what is called the Avoda service. In the ancient temple in Jerusalem, if you've ever been on the Temple Mount, you know it's a big, giant platform that the first temple didn't have such a big platform, but the second temple, built by Herod and enlarged by Herod, and built out the area that today contains the mosque, the Gold Dome Mosque, and the Al-Aqsa Mosque. In the ancient temple, there were different sections. There was what was called the Ezrat Nashim, the women's section, but that meant anybody could go in the women's section. There was the section that was men only. There was a section that was only for the Levites and the Kohanim, and there was a section that ultimately was only for the Kohen Gadol. That was the high priest who would go into the Holy of Holies one time a year on this very day at this very time. The Avoda service is the recollection of that moment when the high priest would enter the Holy of Holies and recite God's secret four-letter name. The name that has been lost to history. The name that died with the last Kohen Gadol. Yud-Heh-Vav-Heh. The very breath of life. And in the ancient temple, the Levites, the musicians and assistant and his priests, would stand on 15 steps that would come from the Ezrat Nashim, from the general area, up to the sacred altar where sacrifices would be brought. 15 steps higher and higher and higher in holiness. And there the Levites on those steps would play their instruments and sing the Psalms, just like we have today, the Book of Psalms. And when it says in the Book of Songs, Shir HaMa'alot, a song of the Ma'alot, a song of the rising, a song of the heavens. That says this was a song that was sung on the 15 steps of the temple. It's actually a location. So this service is designed in the afternoon to evoke that grand time when the scapegoat was sent out to Azazel and the high priest would transfer the sins of the Jewish people onto the goat. And your sins would be set free. And you would be set free, too, for the year ahead. Thank goodness we're not dealing with goats today. But we evoke that memory, that sacred and holy memory, at this time, in this part of our day, because it's your chance to send forth the last of your sins out, away from you, away from our community, out, out, and away. To cleanse yourself as the gates of heaven at Nila will start to close. Page 446. In ancient Israel, the priests performed ceremonies that brought forth blood from animals, rituals in which we cannot imagine ourselves participating. Yet our forebears believed in their efficacy and found them spiritually uplifting. What meaning can those rites and words have for us, Jews of a different time and sensibility? Some see them as artifacts from a bygone era, but they have a deeper meaning if we think of them not as remote and inaccessible objects in a museum, but as something close to our hearts, family heirlooms. Heirlooms, we treasure them, we preserve them for posterity. Their beauty is in the heart and eye of the beholder. A family heirloom has the power to tell us who we are, and by showing us where we came from, it reminds us of a cherished past. It adorns special occasions in our lives. An heirloom's meaning transcends the historical moment. What is the enduring meaning of avodah for us? What do we have in common with the Jews of antiquity who hallowed the rituals of Yom Kippur? We have a hunger for the spiritual. Like our ancestors, we long to transcend the limits of our personal existence and connect to our source. We have the capacity to grow in spirit. Like our ancestors, we sense that our own words and actions can bring us closer to God or distance us from the divine presence. We yearn to express our gratitude and confess our sins. Though God does not need our gifts, the generous act of offering thanks to God makes us better human beings. Though God does not need our words, we feel the need to articulate our moral failures and our commitment to tshuva. We have a longing to begin again. Like our ancestors, we yearn to wipe the slate clean and start our lives afresh with renewed energy and determination. Together, we who gather on the Day of Atonement are not visitors to a museum. We come together as members of a family. Our family's traditions, its stories and beliefs, its ceremonies and collective memories go back more generations than we can count. We are blessed. Our heirlooms bind us, teach us, and remind us. They draw us near to those who came before us, and they pave the way to a life of purpose.
Open up our eyes.
Page 505.
Teach us how to live. Fill our hearts with joy and all the love you have to give. Gather us in peace as you lead us to your name, and we will know that.
Page 505. To do justice, to love goodness, and to walk humbly with your God. What does this verse imply? Taught Rabbi Elazar, to do justice means act in accordance with the principles of justice. To love goodness means to let your actions be guided by the principles of loving kindness. To walk humbly with your God means assist needy families with their funerals and weddings. And Rashi taught further by giving modestly in private to help them meet their expenses.
Open up our
Page 510. Long ago, One word on the lips of one person in one place at one moment brought together four dimensions of the holy. When the high priest would enter the Holy of Holies on Yom Kippur and utter the name of God. And now, every place we lift our eyes to God is a Holy of Holies. Created in the image of God, we are all high priests. Every day of our life lived in love is a Yom Kippur. Every word that we speak in truth is the name of God. We pray from the Holy of Holies in our hearts. Our God and God of all generations before us, may it be your will in the coming year to grant us, as we pray responsively, a year of abundance and atonement,
a year of blessings bestowed and received,
a year of community and compassion,
a year of delight and exaltation,
a year of enlightenment,
a year of friendship and forgiveness,
a year of going up in gladness to the land of Israel,
a year of health and healing and humor,
a year of inner strength and well-being,
a year of joy and Jewish celebrations,
a year of knowledge and learning for its own sake,
a year of love between parents and children, friends and spouses, brothers and sisters,
a year of mitzvot and a moment of sweetness,
a year of nature protected and enjoyed,
a year of optimism and hope,
a year of peace pursued with perseverance,
a year of quiet and tranquility,
a year of rain in its season,
a year of song and spiritual growth,
a year of Torah study and tikkun olam,
a year of understanding and unity,
a year of vows fulfilled and violence overcome,
a year of wisdom acquired and shared,
a year of coexistence among the families of the earth,
a year of young and old reaching out to one another,
a year of Zion aglow with the light for us and all the world.
Our God and God of the generations before us, grant us a year of gratitude to you for the most profound of blessings, your gift of life. Faith does not spring out of nothing. It comes with the discovery of the holy dimension of our existence. We're about to enter Nila, the moments, the closing moments of our Yom Kippur rituals, where we imagine the gates of heaven to close for the new year. And yet, they're left open just a crack. Some say through Sukkot, Hoshana Rabbah and Shmini Atzeret and Simchat Torah, in case something occurs to you after you leave here. Some say the gates of heaven are open to everyone whose heart is broken, who sheds a tear in sorrow. For in that tear, though the tear runs down your face, your prayer will rise and find its way through the gates of heaven into the heart of God. This holy season, this time of atonement, is almost over. And at the end of Nila, we will switch from atonement and forgiveness to themes of abundance and joy and growth and harvest and renewal as Sukkot makes its way with the full moon on Sunday night. You see, it doesn't end at Nila. Our holy days continue. Because if you only leave here having thought about judgment and atonement, and the things that you've missed the mark, but you don't forget to understand that the joy and celebration of life is what these next 2 weeks are about, then you'll only, this year, you won't rise
to all of your potential. We can't only walk in the negative. Our tradition teaches look to the positive. And so, Nila, as the gates are closing, say your last, say your prayers, and get ready to roll with Sukkot, a time of abundance and love and joy and family and guests and welcome. And know that the year ahead is full of joy for you.
When hope is hiding her face, and you're half an inch away from the world, when all you feel's out of place, and the flag of your fixation's unfurled, it's a fine line between a groove and a rut. The blink of an eye between an amputation and a paper cut. If you do what you've always done, you get what you've always got. And you'll be who you've always been, you go where you've always gone. Now your heart's on injured reserve, on what's over and done. In the search for what you thought you deserved, you're left behind when everyone else moves on. It's a fine line between a groove and a rut, the blink of an eye between an amputation and a paper cut. If you do what you've always done, you get what you always got, and you'll be who you've always been. You go where you've always gone. If you do what you've always done, you get what you've always got, and you'll be who you've always been. You go where you've always gone. It's a fine line. Of an eye, and you're never gonna know if you're never gonna try. If you do what you've always done, you get what you've always got, and you'll be who you've always been. You go where you've always gone. If you do what you've always done, you get what you've always got, and you'll be who you've always been. You go where you've always gone. Go where you've always gone.
We continue with our final Amidah on page 622. We rise together. We continue silently through page 639.
Patach lanu sha'ar, be'et ne'lat sha'ar, kifana yom. Open a gate for us when the gates are being closed, for the day is about to fade. The day shall end, the sun shall set. Let us enter your gates, Holy One, we pray together. Please be patient. Please pardon and forgive. Please show compassion. Please lead us to atonement and help us. Please help us to conquer injustice and triumph over sin. Page 644. We continue at the bottom of the page.
Adonai, Adonai. El rachum vechanun erech apayim v'rav chesed v'emet notzer chesed l'alafim nosei avon v'afesha v'chata v'enake.
Adonai, Adonai, God compassionate, gracious, endlessly patient, loving and true, showing mercy to the thousandth generation, forgiving evil, defiance and wrongdoing, and granting pardon. On page 646, Moses prayed to God, as you have been faithful to this people ever since Egypt, please forgive their failings now, in keeping with your boundless love.
Adonai, Adonai, El Rachum Vechanun, Erech Apayim, V'Rav Chesed Ve'emet, Notzer Chesed L'Alafim, Nosei Avon V'Afesha, V'Chata V'Nake.
Vayomer Adonai Salachti Kidvarecha, and God responded, I forgive as you have asked. Page 648. Tzlach lanu avinu ki chatanu, mechal lanu malkenu ki fashanu. Forgive us, Avinu, for we have strayed. Pardon us, Malkenu, for succumbing to sin. You are generous in granting forgiveness, all loving to those who reach out to you.
Adonai, Adonai, El Rachum Vechanun, Erech Apayim, V'Rav Chesed Ve'emet, Notzer Chesed La'alafim, Nosei Avon V'Afesha V'Chata V'Nakeh.
Eloheinu ve'elohei avotenu v'imotenu, Selach lanu, mechal lanu, kaper lanu. Our God and God of our fathers and mothers, forgive us, pardon us, grant us atonement. We continue with Ashamnu, our communal confession, page 653.
I did, 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 I Ashamnu,
Ashamnu,
Bagadnu,
Bagadnu,
Gazalnu,
Gazalnu,
Dibarnu Dolfi,
Dibarnu Dolfi,
I did, I did, I did, I Vehirshanu,
Vehirshanu,
Zadnu,
Zadnu,
Chamasnu,
Chamasnu,
Tafalnu Shaker,
Tafalnu Shaker,
I did, I did, I did, I did, I did, I did, I Yatsnu Ra,
Yatsnu Ra,
Kizavnu,
Kizavnu,
Latsnu,
Latsnu,
Maradnu,
Maradnu,
Niatsnu,
Niatsnu,
Sararnu,
Sararnu,
Avinu,
Avinu,
Pashanu,
Pashanu,
Tsararnu,
Tsararnu,
Kishinu Oref,
Kishinu Oref,
Rashanu,
Rashanu,
Shichatnu,
Shichatnu,
Tiavnu,
Tiavnu,
Tainu,
Tainu,
Titanu,
Titanu,
I did, 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 I
of these wrongs, we are guilty. We betray. We steal, we scorn, we act perversely, we are cruel, we scheme, we are violent, we slander, we devise evil, we lie, we ridicule, we disobey, we abuse, we defy, we corrupt, we commit crimes, we are hostile, we are stubborn, we are immoral, we kill, we spoil, we go astray, we lead others astray.
Everyone on this Yom Kippur day, everyone needs to hear the words, I forgive you. So I'm going to just ask you to turn to the people near you, even if you don't know them very well. I'm going to ask you to just say, I'm sorry, I apologize. They might not know what you're apologizing about, but you know. And then that person's going to say, I forgive you. And you're going to turn around and do it to each other. Because we all need to hear it on this Yom Kippur day. So just take a minute. Hey, you guys. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I apologize. I'll forgive you this time.
I'm sorry. I forgive you.
may I suggest to you, may I suggest this is the best part of your life. May I suggest this time is blessed for you. This time is blessed and shining almost blinding bright. Just turn your head and you'll begin to see a thousand reasons that were just beyond your sight. The reasons why I suggest this is the best part of your life. There is a world that's been expressed in you, addressed to you, intended only for your eyes. A secret world, like a treasure chest to you, of private scenes and brilliant dreams that mesmerize. A lover's trusting smile, a tiny baby's hand, loving stars that fill the turning sky at night. Oh, I suggest this is the best part of your life. There is a hope that's been expressed in you, the hope of seven generations, maybe more. This is the faith that they invest in you, is that you'll do one better than was done before. Inside you understand, inside you know what's yours to finally set right. As I suggest to you, as I suggest, this is the best part of your life. This is a song, comes from the west to you, comes from the west, comes from the slowly setting sun. They request of you, to see how very short the endless days will run. When the dark descends, oh, we'd give anything for one more hour of light. And I suggest this is the best part of your life. Yes, I suggest this is the best part of your life.
Page 659. Together we pray. We loved and we wept. We were kind and spoke thoughtfully. We were faithful and trusting. We put forth effort. We were mindful. We embraced. We took delight in the holy books. We were creative. And we yearned. We fought for justice and searched out the good. We tried our best and we were attentive. We did what you commanded us to do. We found meaning in Torah, and most of the time we did what is right. We proclaimed your name and we were accepting. We were joyful and we cared.
My way, I stumble and fall. I fail to see the open door and only see the wall. Sometimes I close my ears when open they should be, but then I stop and listen to
that still small voice inside of me. Pitchuli,
Pitchuli,
Share Tzedek,
Share Tzedek,
Avova,
Avova,
Odeya,
Odeya,
Pitchuli,
Pitchuli,
Share Tzedek,
Share Tzedek,
Avova,
Avova,
Odeya. Spark inside the darkness and the gates open for me. Pitchuli,
Pitchuli,
Share Tzedek,
Share Tzedek,
Avova,
Avova,
Odeya,
Odeya,
Pitchuli,
Pitchuli,
Share Tzedek, Avova,
to come to our bima, to open the ark as we come to the final moments of our Yom Kippur day. Hope, please join us. Let us turn to page 664 for the final Avinu Malkeinu and our final Vidui, the end of our day, that we will arise in just a few moments, fresh and pure and clean and forgiven and healed, filled with hope and joy and blessing for the new year. Gentlemen, open the ark. Grab it.
Avinu Malkeinu, Boneinu Vaneinu. Avinu Malkeinu, Boneinu Vaneinu, Ki ein banu maasi. Maaseh imanu, tzedaka v'chesed.
Big congregation at this moment. So if you'd like to come down in this area, just being close to the ark up here, if you want to come out from your seat and come close, you're welcome to do so. If you want to stay where you are, you can. No pressure. The vidui is the final confession. It's actually the same that we say on our deathbeds.
This is supposed to be the last breath of the old you. It's the death of the old you right now. And soon as the shofar sounds, it will be the birth of the new you for the new year, the year that you want it to become for you. Take a deep breath, almost your final breaths of that old you. Page 672, we sing the Shema once. We sing Baruch Shem Kavod Malchuto Leolam Va'ed three times. And then we affirm God's essential oneness and faith in our God, Adonai Hu Elohim, seven times. 1, 3, and 7, holy numbers in our tradition.
Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Baruch Shem Kevod Malchuto Leolam Vaed. Baruch Shem Kevod Malchuto Leolam Vaed. Baruch Shem Kevod Malchuto Leolam Vaed. Adonai Hu Elohim, Adonai. Shivarim Teruah Tekiah Gedolah
are closing, let this new year lift us higher towards life. Let it be a time of living our dreams, of turning towards our family and friends, and expressing the love in our hearts. Let this be the new year of strength for you, for your family, for our congregation, and a year of shalom. of peace of heart and mind and home and world. Yivarecha Adonai v'yishmerecha, Ya'er Adonai panav ilecha v'yichunecha, Yisa Adonai panav ilecha v'yasem lecha shalom. May the Holy One of Blessing grant to all whom you love life, health, prosperity, security, and an ancient gift of shalom, peace. Ken yehi ratzon. So may it be God's will. We join in Havdalah to separate this holy moment from the week that is about to unfold, to finish, and we join together.
Yai lai da 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 da
Eliyahu Hatishbi, Eliyahu, Eliyahu.
for being part of this holy community during these high holy days of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, for bringing your spirit and energy. Again, to Lori Black, who's added so much to our music, to Aline, our amazing pianist for this year. I thank again Jeremy Gimbel, our amazing, wonderful, beloved Jeremy. And we thank Max for adding his music and his wisdom. To our ushers, many of you are ushers who have done so much. To our Pillar 3, which has done so much to help prepare for these holy days. Would you thank the office staff on your way out? And if you run into Arturo, thank Arturo as well. He's worked very hard to make our holy days so complete. We'd be remiss without thanking our Board of Trustees. They've worked very hard to make it to here. So we thank you all for your service. And we conclude with Hatikva and Motzi. If you'll join us in Hatikva. Tarunai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Hamotzi Lechem Min Haaretz. Ayavon, Bateavon, everyone. There's more challah out in the lobby. Drive safely home. Happy New Year. Friday night, 8 o'clock. Sunday at 6.